This time I'm coming to you from my dining room, and Jordan here, he's been working on a project lately, and he's put a lot of time into it, and I think it turned out really cool, and he was so anxious to show you that he's got me up here at 6 in the morning filming it so I can show you. And what he's built here is a gun that's in that sort of steampunk aesthetic, I guess is what you would call it. You know, part of that steampunk movement, and from what I gather, steampunk is kind of like what would have happened if, you know, they had taken Victorian era inventions and they had continued with that technology, but you know, kept with the same basic, you know, format. Like, you know, what if steam power had gone into almost, you know, 20th century technology, or, you know, clockwork mechanisms, you know, that sort of thing. But anyway, and that's kind of what he did here, and because he really likes that look of the brass and the copper and the steampunk kind of thing, and that's what he was going for. And basically what he's constructed here is a rifle, and it's basically a laser gun. But with the look of that old time, you know, brass and copper steam technology. So, and I'll kind of, you know, Jordan here, you know, of course he's the one that built it, and I had nothing to do with this project, so he can claim every bit of this. And I really think it turned out awesome. And he can kind of tell you what the various parts are. Here, I'll just give you a quick overview here, and then he can point to it and tell you real quick. So up here, basically, like we said, it's a laser gun. So this would be like your laser emitter, yeah, I guess.
That was actually a towel holder.
And if you can see that, that's made out of brass, and it's like the end of a, you said the end of a towel rod, basically. And then it's got these awesome little things he built here out of wood, and they're painted.
I cut those out of the Dremel.
In like a copper color. And then this barrel, what's that made of? Is that metal?
Yeah, it's metal. All
right, so it's actually got a steel barrel there. And then underneath, he's got this bar wrapped in a...
it's coated copper wire.
Yeah, like a, coated copper wire. That's just the same wire, I believe, that's on those coils that come in the hair trimmers, the ones you might have seen in my other videos. And then as we work our way up...
This is a cover off of an airsoft shotgun I had that I painted in the brass color.
Oh, okay. So this is like a perforated kind of, I guess you call it a heat shield or something. And he painted it that copper color just to keep with that, you know, that look. And then, and the coolest part, I think, is this, he actually used a brass candle holder for a scope, you know. And you can actually, you know, of course it's got a hole through it, so see, you can actually look all the way through there, so that's kind of cool. And up here,
I used
he's got some gearing.
Some gears out of a telephone.
Okay, and that's supposed to be like your
wind adjustment.
Like, yeah, like windage and elevation, I guess, for your scope. That's kind of neat. It actually turns, which is, you know, pretty cool.
If you turn it that way, it spins a little thing on the bottom.
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty neat. And then along the side here, you can see he's got like a piece of decorative brass. We have no idea what that came off
of.
It's
just a trim piece.
But he found it in one of my parts bins that I use for my guitars. And it's kind of got a fleur-de-lis kind of look to it, I guess. And then back here, what's going on with this?
This is a light cover, light switch cover, or even an outlet cover.
Mm-hmm.
And inside of it, I put some gears from an old cuckoo clock we had that was all busted up.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So you got kind of a clockwork mechanism in there. Pretty neat. And then, and this is kind of a big deal, I think. Pretty cool. Is that he, if you look at this stock... And it's actually one piece of wood. Like, he took a goblet. Yeah, but I mean, the wood, it had to be like at least a 2x12 or something. And then he cut this out, and then he used a Dremel, he said?
Yeah, the whole thing was, yeah.
So he Dremeled these holes out for like, can you show them how like your hand fits in there?
Yeah, I looked at some old Heckler & Koch rifles online to get an idea of what I wanted for my stock and how my fingers were going to go around through the handle.
But I mean, I just thought he did an excellent job on there. You can see how he, you know, whittled out that trigger guard.
That was
and
hard.
That thumb hole. I mean, that was a lot of wood to move out of there. And that's pretty cool. And I don't know how well it's showing up on there, but you kind of aged the stock too, so it had a little bit of
dark stain
history to it. You know, I guess we can try to spin it a little bit. You want to do that? Turn around. We'll look at the other side here.
Oh, I broke it.
Going
so
a little
long
with the speed up here. Sorry. But on the other side here, you can see he's got some more like copper tubing, just to kind of keep with that steam era type technology. And then up here, just to give it, the look of electricity, and illustrate how it could produce the laser. He's got some spark plugs, and they're wrapped in that same wire that he used underneath the barrel there. So that's pretty cool.
The way I built the scope mount was it was basically just a C that goes into the side of the gun and comes mm-hmm. back up and over. It doesn't connect at all other than the one part of the bottom.
Yeah, that's kind of cool actually. You can turn it. And maybe you can see.
It just connects right here.
Yeah.
That's it.
So the scope mount just comes off one side, bends across, and then holds that scope on there. So that's kind of neat. But anyway, you can kind of hold it up so they can see that it fits like a regular rifle. Oh, and he did make that little base there out of a
that's just something I put together
out of an old picture frame and stuff, so it'd have something to hold it.
I'm going to try to improve that later.
And anyway, and you can see that it does fit your hand really well, and the stock fits against your shoulder and everything like a real rifle. But I thought it was a pretty cool looking thing. I really do. I was kind of proud of him, you know. But anyway, wow, this is getting to be about a 7-minute video, so I guess we're going to go ahead and call this one done. And hopefully, you know, if you're not familiar with the steampunk kind of thing, you can look that up. You know, it's kind of that Jules Verne, you know, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea type of stuff. But I think it's pretty cool myself, and I thought he did a really good job. So anyway, glad you guys took the time to watch this, and thanks for, you know, any comments or anything. And I'll see you later. Bye.